The festival of Holi has just passed by, and more than the happiness, for so many it has been a nightmare. People have been hurt, beaten up, even stabbed. The issue of balloons with semen being thrown on girls is in greatest distaste. May the culprits be legally corrected. It happened when at one side boys and men were lauding Sri Devi, their fan, for the entertainer she has been. But what a sham! On one side praise for the works of woman, and on the other side you insult woman. Padman got released in Feb, and though one cannot say it was a super hit, it definitely was an eye-opener to the needs of women in a male-dominated India. A welder in a small village in Tamil Nadu loved his wife enough to give her better conditions during her menstrual cycle days. He went on to create a machine to produce cheap and economically viable sanitary pads. That raises the question that if Muruganathan could produce cheap sanitary pads, why do sanitary pads cost so much in a chemist? And to add to that, last year has seen 12% GST added to it. No one could leave a chemist without shelling out at least 60 rupees for 2 to 4 days a month. For the rich and the middle class, this may be fine, but not all women belong to this category of the economy. What about them? Don't they matter? Women are often forced to go without sanitary protection during their menstrual cycle, or make do of some random cloths torn from some old clothes, etc. Often their husbands don't even know what happens to them. Mama's boys with no education from their mama. An A.C. Nielsen study showed that nearly 93% of girls missed at least 2 days of school monthly due to menstruation reasons being pain and discomfort, others being shame or fear of staining clothes. This is because there is no proper education and also no proper sanitary protection in rural areas available at cheaper rates. If the government wants to make the Beti Bachao, Beti Padhao a success, it must look into this matter as related to the education of the girl child. In 2017, Sushmita Dev, an MP, created a change.org petition addressed to Arun Jaitley to remove tax from the sanitary pads. But after 11 months, when the petition was received, Maneka Gandhi, Union Minister for Women and Child Development, has just sat upon it. Wake up, woman! As Joyce Sebastian points out in her article, tax on sanitary pads are tax on womanhood. Friends, periods are not a choice. They are what prepare women for childbirth. Let us respect women who are future mothers, in the name of our own mothers. Donate your attention, not only your money, to the empowerment of the girl child and of the woman. Wish you a happy Women's Day on the 8th of March. May every woman who comes into your life or who has been part of your life be something which you will cherish.